In terms of the benefits of the, what are you able to do better now that you've had these injections after your surgery?
Well, I have less pain. So
in my particular practice, the anesthesiologist, I deal with patients with chronic pain. And some of those patients with chronic low back pain require facet injections. And they're done specifically both for two things, for diagnosis, where is the patient's pain coming from?
That's kind of where the spot is, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
Cold soap? It's just alcohol.
We then will clean the patient's back with alcohol and iodine solution or just alcohol alone.
Excellent. You're very patient with me.
Then after that, we will administer local anesthesia.
Pinch, burn.
Once we've determined we've given the right type of injection in the right place, we then will do another examination to make sure, do you feel a difference?
How's the leg feel?
Now, the majority of patients that I see want to be very active. They want to be healthy. They want to get back to their activities of daily living.
The thought process is how to decrease that nerve inflammation.
I often use, in my particular practice, antidepressants, anti-seizure medications, non-steroidals, perhaps injection therapy, so they can return to their activities of daily living. They can return to work.
We can get the sedation.
Sometimes patients come to me with a prescription for me to perform a certain procedure. Medical care means you have a conversation with that patient, because sometimes the best care is the more conservative care that does not involve an injection. Injections have inherent risk. They have expenses. The dangers of any injections that anyone will do are bleeding, infection, paralysis, nerve damage.
So the dye that we inject lights up the nerve.
The biggest risk of these particular injections is that we're so close to the spinal cord and column and the nerves that exit out of the back.
All right, let me take a picture of you up here, okay?
Physicians are the only ones that I know that have the ability to use a fluoroscopy machine so we can see the exact target. And it has to be pinpoint accuracy. Anything beyond that can harm the patient.
Goes down the leg.
As a physician, I know how to manage when to use that needle, how to place the needle.
That's my finger.
But lastly, if there is a complication, I as a physician then have the ability to then manage it.
Can you rotate the C-arm?
And the reason why we've done that is because of medical school, our education, and our specialty training program as anesthesiologists. You can't see or measure judgment. You can see procedures, but you can't see what that physician, he or she, is thinking in terms of how to care for that patient. And we need to be very cautious because a lot of these medications that we use, especially for chronic pain, have very addictive potentials, have tolerance potentials. Sometimes patients come to me in my practice with narcotic therapy or opiates. I deal with narcotics in the operating room all day long. And we have a tremendous high safety profile with that, with these powerful medications. So often these patients come to me, they're physically dependent on the medication. If they don't take their medication, they feel terrible. They're in a no-win situation.
Did you find the pain relief or something was better than the narcotic therapy?
Oh, definitely.
We have that ability to know anatomy and physiology and pharmacology to know what is going to be the best therapy.
Ibuprofen works fairly well.
Right. But I love when patients come to me with a lot of questions.
Do you sleep good at night or not?
Sleep is good.
You should always investigate who is the physician caring for you. If you need more information, you know, please go to the American Society of Anesthesiologists website, which is lifelinetomodernmedicine.com.
First is going to be a bad bee sting in the small of your back.
My biggest concern is for patient care and patient safety. And I think we should do is maintain physician care of these patients with chronic pain. Any change in this will open it up to patients undergoing procedures that are not necessary, patients undergoing riskier procedures with untrained personnel. This is where spending money the right way will save money in the long run.
So we got about another minute, okay?
We want to make sure that the government, insurance companies are just not spending money unnecessarily. These are my concerns. If there are any changes or possible changes to legislation in terms of a scope of practice on who can handle that needle. It's more than just the needle placement. It's their skill set in terms of their education. Do they understand really what they're doing?
Right. right here. That's the nerve right there. Physicians and anesthesiologists who have specialized in pain medicine, this is all that we do.
Excellent.
When we do procedures as anesthesiologists for chronic pain, they're very dangerous, and they must always be maintained by a physician.